And good afternoon and welcome to the final game of our IAAM series here, the B Conference Championships. This game is between the Park Bruins and the St. John's Catholic Prep Vikings. I'm Larry Dukes with Morgan Knox. Morgan on the camera, and we're going to be bringing you the play-by-play of tonight's contest. Teams going through stick checks at the moment, and then we will have introductions of the reserves and the starters for both teams by our stadium announcer, followed by our national anthem, and we'll be ready for some exciting lacrosse action in our nightcap here in just a little bit, about 10 minutes to be exact. So we hope you enjoy the contest, and we'll turn our sound down and we'll be back to you in just a few moments. We'll let the stadium announcer handle the introductions, and we'll catch up with you in just a moment. Defense, Ariel Dunn, Katie Cochran, the introductory festivities is concluded. We're ready for some lacrosse action here at William Tierney Field at USA Lacrosse. And I'm joined by former Hofstra player, a coach.
Check, check, is this thing on?
Wow. And humorist, all in one. Morgan Knox. Morgan, what do you look for in this this contest?
Well, it's not raining, so that's good news for them. I definitely think, again, I said this in our last game and I said this last night off air, I think it's going to come down to who's going to come off hot off the first draw control, set the tempo for the game going forward.
Yeah, we've noticed that in every one of the previous contests, how important draw control is. And unforced errors, just keep from making those mistakes, the jitters of the championship game, those that can keep the game within their own head, usually prevail.
Exactly. It's going to come down to who's going to strike first, though, I think, for this tempo to be set here quick in the first half.
Okay, we're ready for the draw. And it is controlled by St. John's. .35 for St. John's is Christina Hindle. She gives up to number 25, Maya Graham. Looks inside, shot, score! Right off the bat, Payson Walker for St. John's, a sophomore, puts it in the back of the net. And St. John's with the early 1-0 lead.
I like that nice fast ball movement that I see right off the bat from the Vikings. I mean, they're dodging with their heads up. They're making quick decisions, and see all that in the first 30 seconds of this game. It's going to be a good game to look forward to.
You're absolutely right. Boy, that happened quick. A whole 30 seconds into the game, we have our first goal. Back to the draw for St. John's, Kaylee Storm. Ground ball, controlled by number 22, Grace Galanis. Over to number 19, Alex Kopsel. And then Grace Galanis. Now Kaylee Storm gives it up to Christina Hindle. Hindle spins. Look, taken away by Park. Good solid defense, number 21. Ridgely Smith. Smith up the sidelines, far sideline. And give it a push. And continuance. And she brings it down and slows it down. Over to Cassandra Kitchen. Kitchen moves the ball in front. Shot, score! And Park answers. I believe it was Abby Kaplan from Park knotting it up. We'll wait for the official announcement.
Okay, and that was a Park goal assisted by number 24, Cassandra Kitchen. Scored by number 11, Abby Kaplan.
Yes, it was Abby Kaplan for the goal. Back to 1-1. And just over a minute into the game, we have a score by both teams. And violation goes over to St. John's. And they'll bring it down. and set it up. Maya Graham up on top, moves it around the perimeter, and they'll take it back behind the net. And back around Kaylee Storm to Christina Hindel. And it's going to go all the way around again. Movement convergence in the front of the net. Goes to the back. And a violation.
I like that the Vikings are settling and taking their time and working that ball around and really making sure that they're getting the best look and the best opportunity that they can. We haven't seen that from a team yet, really settling it down and getting the ball around, get everybody a touch, get everybody comfortable.
And we're going to get a shot and a score! And it went top left, top right. With the,
and that was the same
shot and score.
Number 35, Christina Hindel.
Christina Hindel, the junior, picks up the second goal of the game for St. John's. St. John's comes to this championship undefeated in the conference. They went 10-0 in the season, beating Friends in the semifinals. And the draw taken by number 24, Cassandra Kitchen, for Park. We'll see if Park has the same discipline on offense as we just saw from St. John's. Ball slowed down and worked around. Over to number two, Meredith White. And now number 18, Elizabeth Rosenbaum. Over to 11, Abby Kaplan. And loose ball. And it's going to get turned over. Nope, we're going to get a spot here. Abby Kaplan pulls it out. And didn't see the opening there, so she'll move it around. Some quick feet, on goal, shot no good. And behind the net, Park controls. Quick feet, spin, look, nothing there. And we got a push. It'll be Park ball. Giving it to number 26, Keenan Clark. Keenan, a sophomore. And a jump. Movement in and shot. And a save.
Great save.
Really nice save by Juliana Workman. She clears it out, gets it up to number 21, I believe, Kaylee Storm, who now controls at the top. Morgan, as you said, they move it very quickly over into the attacks area, but then they set things up. They like to set play.
Yeah, it's one of those things that we talked about in the last game. They're taking their breaks when they get down on offense. They control the tempo of the game.
Shot and score! Beautiful pass. Rocket into the top of the net. I think that was Payson Walker, number 11.
I'm seeing a pattern here on the Vikings offense, the draw and dump. And they do it very well.
Assisted by number 25, Isabel Angel. I'm so sorry. That was St. John's goal by number 11, Payson Walker, assisted by number 25, Maya Green.
Corrections by the stadium announcer. We're correct. Goal by Payson Walker, sophomore. And we're back to the draw. And St. John's with a 3-1 lead. And control will be given to St. John's. Addison Scanlon as she brings it across. Over to her teammate, Christina Hindel. And over to Kaylee Storm. Very disciplined approach by St. John's. Certainly controlling the tempo of play. St. John's wanting things to go at their pace. And so far it's working for them. A 3-1 lead. Movement in front. Shot. Score! Addison Scanlon with the goal. She's a junior. And that makes the score 4-1 St. John's. And we have a timeout on the field by the Park Bruins needing to regroup. Morgan, it looks like Park playing a little bit on their heels on defense. Looks like they're waiting for the action to come to them. What do you think?
MedStar Health is the official medical partner of USA.
I think Park is smart to take a timeout here. I think they need to regroup, come in with a game plan, and kind of not let the Vikings of St. John's control the game. I think you're going to see a more aggressive defense when they come out, and I think there's going to be certain personnel that they're going to start to latch onto a little bit harder.
Gotcha. I see the same thing. I don't think that they can allow St. John's to control the tempo of play, or this game could get away from them pretty quickly. They've got to set the tempo. And so if that means pressing them when they're walking around or getting into their set positions or pressuring the person that is their quarterback, so to speak, at the top of the play, they need to do something different.
Right. And it's still early in the game. I mean, with 18 minutes left in the first half, the other thing is, if you're the Vikings, you can't let your foot off the gas. You cannot be comfortable with a 3-goal lead because, as we've learned, the game can flip on a dime.
It can. Very streaky. We've seen the other two championship games. We've seen a 4-goal lead turn into a 2-goal deficit in a matter of a few minutes. So everyone taking their positions back on the field, and we'll have a draw for St. John's. It'll be Kaylee Storm, and for Park, it's going to be Cassandra Kitchen on the draw. Launched and taken. What a move. Going to net. Shot. Score! Beautiful move by Keenan Clark. Takes it to the goal. And suddenly, Morgan, it only took about 15 seconds to turn this thing into a new game.
Larry, I think it took under 10. I think we were at 17:55.
Yeah, Cassandra Kitchen, an IAAM Player of the Week, really helped the Bruins top the Friends School. And now, here in the championship game, maybe that spark that gets them going really to make this a much stronger championships than it was looking like it might be. 4-2 here in the first half, 17:47 remaining. You're right. It was 8 seconds. 8 seconds off the faceoff and a goal for the Bruins. So we'll try it again. This time, Christina Hindle. But Kitchen wins it again. And this time, her teammate, Keenan Clark, will take it behind the net. And an unforced error. Errant pass goes over to St. John's.
Larry, that move they call walking the dog.
And it looks very much like a dog on a leash. Pretty effective. Hard to reach that unless you've got some good wheels. St. John's in the same offensive setup as they've been all game. Not seeing too much new on defense by Park. And here we go. Park making a move. Finds. And loss of the headgear eyewear. That's number 5 for St. John's, Amelia Tippett. And she's going to be given the free ball. Park was making a move to double team that left her open. And she goes to goal and takes one to the head. And there's a yellow card being issued. And off comes number 24 for Park, Cassandra Kitchen, one of their biggest weapons. She'll be spending 2 minutes in the sin bin.
Anytime a referee sees a stick come out of a vertical position into another player, they're most likely going to blow their whistle.
Yep, and doesn't help that the eyewear went flying as well. Shot and score!
And she capitalized off of that.
Took all of 2 seconds to make that happen.
St. John's goal number 5, Amelia Tippett.
Amelia Tippett with the score, making it 5-2. That'll release Kitchen from the hot seat and back onto the field for the draw. So we'll go to the draw with Christina Hindle from St. John's.
I think the sun's out.
No. Somebody call Sue Thompson. She made it happen. The sun is out here at USA Lacrosse. And we are drying out after a day full of rain. Mist. But we're having fun. On the draw, winning the draw is St. John's. Number 35, that's Christina Hindle. And they'll set it up yet again. Ball moves behind the net. Back in front. Shot, score! Oh, crease violation called by the official. No goal. And it goes over to Park, to Kitchen, up to number 26, Keenan Clark. And what a quick turnaround, as now Park will take it behind the St. John's net. Back out on top. Juke move, no. And scores! Wow.
A little bit of a change-up pitch there, it looks like.
Yeah, it looks like we did get the change-up. Normally a rocket turns into be a floater into goal for Park. But you know what, Morgan?
A
on
goal
the scoreboard,
is a goal.
It all looks the same, doesn't it?
Exactly.
5-3, St. John's over Park.
I'm looking forward to more Park possessions where they're setting up in that balanced offense and they're getting into a set or a play in order to kind of get in their groove, so to say.
Yeah, it seems like both teams have the same approach. One so far has gotten there more times than the other. So 5-3 here in the first half, 14:35 remaining. The faceoff for St. John's, Maya Graham. And Kitchen for Cassandra Kitchen. She comes up with it for Park. Well, here comes the reverse of the streak that we were seeing a moment ago. And a foul called on number 21 for St. John's, Kaylee Storm. Give the free ball to Ridgely Smith. Ridgely dodges. She shoots. And we're going to get a foul called on St. John's. It'll give Ridgely Smith a free ball from the right side. Ridgely Smith on goal, high shot over the goal. Control behind the net by Park. Out to number two, Meredith White. And swings around to Kitchen, Cassandra Kitchen. Shot! Oh, what a rocket! Sidearm rocket by Kitchen, high over the right shoulder of the goalie, Juliana Workman for St. John's. And now we have a 5-4. Contest.
Put that shot on her highlight reel.
It was a rocket. And it came from the sidearm. It was a really strong shot. And a bit of a riser. It caught the net just above the goalie's shoulder.
I think everyone put their hands together for that one. That was a nice shot.
Sure was. Christina Hindle for St. John's. Back on the draw. Cassandra Kitchen for Park. And this time we're controlled by Keenan Clark.
A little frustration from the Vikings there.
Yep. Kitchen takes it behind the net. Now ducks back and catches the goal with a left hand. That was a beautiful shot as well.
You know, I blinked and I missed it.
It was a really nice step juke. Back around front. Top of the net, left-hander.
Just like that, you can feel the momentum change here.
Yeah, we're knotted up at five. So, needing to see something different here on the draw for St. John's. Hindle Kitchen again. And this time racing to it is St. John's. Number 22, Grace Galanis. And St. John's going to go to work. And a save made by Mac Howie for Park. And racing up down the middle of the field is Elizabeth Rosenbaum for the Bruins. Takes it behind the net. Now the discipline really falling on the side of the Bruins.
Yeah, we see a really uncharacteristic kind of shot from the Vikings offense.
It was way far out and did not have much gas on it.
Parks looking to capitalize off of that turnover.
Spin. And ground ball. Loose ground ball. And Park. White looking at her options in front, shot and score!
Great unselfish play there.
And found the open teammate. Elizabeth Rosenbaum with the score. Elizabeth, a junior, gives Park the lead. I believe that's the first Park lead of the game. 10:43 remains in the first half.
Larry, I just want to note that both teams are actually doing a fifth defender. So instead of four and four behind each restraining line, each defense has decided to add an extra man back there to stop any fast break from happening.
Gotcha. Nice snag on the draw. By number 22 for St. John's, that's Grace Galanis. And back behind the net. Park packing it in a bit, trying to avoid that second pass. Hey, Christina Hindle with the free ball. She goes to goal, shot, score! And Hindle makes it 6-6.
And that was St. John's goal by number 35, Christina Hindle.
9:36 remains in the first half. St. John's Catholic Prep Vikings, 6. Park Bruins, 6. Hindle and Kitchen back for the draw. Goes to St. John's. Poked away, but retained in possession by St. John's. Number 35, Christina Hindle. Addison Scanlon. And tosses it back around. St. John's comfortable running the shot clock down a little bit, getting themselves set, eat some clock. net. In front, shot just high. And out of bounds, it'll be run out of bounds by St. John's. Kaylee Storm in the middle. Pass back in front. Shot. It's also high. Shot in front. Blocked by the goalie. A player down. It's a Park player down. And now back up. The ball is going to get turned over to Park. And goalie Mac Howie gets it out to the sideline in front of the benches. Loose ball picked up by Sandra Kitchen. Then to Rosenbaum. And now the Bruins on attack. Lily Parks in control. The net. Now back out on top. And Park will set it up again. Ridgely Smith. She gets it over to number 18. That's Elizabeth Rosenbaum, and a collision. And there's going to be a yellow card issued here.
Not sure if I would have issued a yellow there.
No,
it looked like think it was honest play, but
yeah,
you know,
inadvertent
I'm not
contact.
Wearing the stripes.
No, not tonight, your night. Not number 36, Addison Scanlon for St. John's. No shot from Keenan Clark. She gives it up. In front, pass, shot, score! Looks like it could have been Ridgely Smith. Senior Ridgely Smith with the goal. Gives the Bruins the lead again, 7-6. With 6:11 remaining in the first half. Same two players on the draw. Hendel and Kitchen. This time advantage Hendel. And Grace Galanis takes it for St. John's. Back and forth battle here at the USA Complex in Hunt Valley, Maryland. William Tierney Field in this B Conference Championship for 2023. And we have a beautiful rainbow now over the water tower. Inside, spin, and taken away by Park. the run goes Kitchen. She gives it up to Keenan Clark. Minutes, 30 seconds remaining in the half. Out in front, Ridgely Smith. Over to Abby Kaplan. Abby Kaplan making a move. A good defense by St. John's. Look in front, movement, and we got a foul. And the ball is going to go over to Park. A free ball. Keenan Clark will now go straight in. And scores! Keenan Clark.
Goal by number 26, Keenan Clark.
Sophomore with the goal gives Park their first two-goal lead, 8-6. Morgan, I think this audience deserves a picture of that rainbow. What do you think? And it is one that goes from end to end, dropping down into Hunt Valley all the way from the water tower. And back on the field, we have our next draw. Still controlled by the Vikings. Moving around front. Shot. And it's going to go over to the Bruins. Ball up the sidelines. Keenan Clark. Two minutes remaining in the half.
That's a connection we've seen a lot tonight, Larry, in transition 24-26.
Yeah, Cassandra Kitchen to Keenan Clark. And it looks like that's the go-to for the goalie. Anybody in the back, kind of move it up the sidelines.
They do it so well, they make it look effortless.
In shot goes wide, and it's going to get turned over to the Vikings. St. John's goes cross field. Addison Scanlon. 45 seconds remaining. Shot blocked in front. Shot again. Nothing there. And a whistle. And we'll sort this all out. And the ball will go to St. John's with 32.5 seconds. Takes an in shot. Save by the Bruins goalie, Mac Howie. Ball moved up on the far sideline. And cleared with just about 10 seconds remaining. Down to 7. And that's going to end a half. And at halftime, our score, the Park Bruins 8, the St. John's Vikings 6. And we'll come back to you in just about 8 minutes as we recap the first half and start the second. We'll be back to you real short. Shortly, we'll leave the video on and turn the sound down and enjoy halftime. We'll be back to you soon. Thank you.
Thank you.
And we're just about ready for the start of the second half. Looked like this was going to be a runaway at the very beginning, as the early lead was by St. John's. But the momentum shifted after a Park timeout, and it was all Park for a while. Things got knotted up, and just before the half, Park got two unanswered goals and leads 8-6. So, Morgan, what do you think? What's going to happen with St. John's here in the second half? What did the coach say at halftime?
I love this game, but I'm the only one ever playing it. What do you think the coach said at halftime?
Well, I think the coach said we need to score some more goals in order to be victors here. And yet I think he probably told them that keep to the discipline, let the game come to you, and stop trying to force stuff.
I agree. I think they definitely had the talk of keep taking your opportunities, but we don't need the unforced shots. We don't need the penalties. Come back out with composure. Take a breath. There's still 25 minutes left in this game. And two goals, we've learned, again, is really nothing.
Yeah, unlike most teams, St. John's came out in the beginning of the game loose and letting the game happen, and then seemed to get stiffer as the half went on when
right.
Park made it a game. I think he said, let's just have some fun. Brett Poncioni is the head coach for St. John's Catholic Prep. What did Robin Lowe say?
Keep your foot on the gas.
There you go. Keep the pressure on. Okay, here we go. Ready for the second half. Fake the draw. Change at the draw. Meredith White took the draw for Park. And it's going to be awarded to St. John's.
You can tell based off that draw controller that the battle is on.
Why do you say that, Morgan?
Both teams, off the start, both look fast. They look re-energized. They both look like they're ready to step up and take control of the game.
Looking front shot. Score! St. John's sends the first salvo with a shot to the bottom left, and we'll wait for the official announcement.
And that was a goal by number 25, Maya Graham.
Maya Graham credited for the goal, junior.
I like the way they started this half, Larry, but we've seen this before, right?
Absolutely.
This is
absolutely
how we started the game. The Vikings started the game, so now the question is, can they keep this up?
Well, there's going to be two draw controls in a row, and we are going right down to our position to set up the offense yet one more time. And the Viking crowd sensing the momentum is shifting. In front, stop, shot, score! And just like that, a minute and 13 seconds in and two goals, and we're knotted up again.
And that was another Viking goal by number 36, Addison Scanlon, assisted by Rylan Piccolo.
Addison Scanlon credited with that goal, number 36. She's also a junior. Christina Hindle is going to take the draw now for St. John's. We're going back to Cassandra Kitchen for Park, hoping to change things up as we are 8-8. And this time it's going to go over to Kitchen and Park. offsides. And Kitchen with the advantage, takes it to the middle, pass. Teammate was not looking, ground ball. Being chased and picked up by, and lost again. There's gonna be white ball. And St. John's making its way up the field, weaving in and out of park players. Over to number one, Gianna Lowry. Gianna Lowry getting obstructed, moving forward. And we got a violation here on Park. And what's the call? Couldn't tell you.
Inadvertent whistle.
Inadvertent whistle was the call. Okay. We'll keep things moving. There's about 8 seconds we won't get back. Look in front. Tough pass. Probably ill-advised to make that pass at that point. Long pass downfield. And it's going to be picked up and taken back. And we have a player go down. And it'll be St. John's possession. And Coach Lowe appealing that call. Pass turns into a turnover and Park possession. Front, poked away by St. John's. Given back to Park. Cassandra Kitchen controls. Look in the middle. Nothing there. Brings it back out. St. John's applying the tenacious defense. Looked in the middle, pass. And taken, but not yet possessed by St. John's. Ball in the corner, out to the goalie. Goalie gets it out, and now St. John's is running. Up the far sideline. Long pass. In the middle, shot, taken away by Park. And now going the other way. Rosenbaum, Kitchen made the play, turned around, got the ball up. And now things settle down. working counterclockwise. Moving in front, shot. Blocked. Back to Park. Duck in, shot. Wide left. And Park retains possession. And the free ball called. For number 26, Keenan Clark. He slips around and scores! Keenan Clark for Park makes it a 9-8 game.
And that was a Park goal. Number 26.
And a yellow card coming out. Grace Galante getting the yellow card. And the control here by Park. Dodge in front, shot. Taken away by St. John's, and they're on a run now. Walking the dog. Up the field, movement to the net, shot. And looks like we have a foul. And the ball is going to get turned over. That was an interesting call. Ball turned over to Park, moved all the way up to Kitchen. Park takes it behind the net. 17 minutes, 25 seconds remaining in regulation. Kitchen spreading people out. Flip in front. Ball lost. Picked up by Park. And it'll stay right here with Park. Over, look in front. Nothing there. Now another movement to the front. Spin. All the way through. Loose ball. Taken away by St. John's. Goalie Juliana Workman will walk it up. Flips it up to Gianna Lowry. Gianna Lowry clears. And as the night settles in here at USA Lacrosse, St. John sets it up, hoping to knot it up. St. John's getting a little rest on offense where you want to rest. And now they pick it up. Cuts the look. Nothing there. Pass. Movement. Cutter. Looking to cut across the middle. Nothing there. And we had a strike here to the head. Addison Scanlon will have it right in front. She shoots and scores! Scanlon with the goal. She knots it up 9-9.
And that was the St. John's goal, number 36, Addison Scanlon.
Larry, that might be the longest stretch of game we've had without a goal.
Yeah, we're down to 14:38 remaining. It was almost, 4 or 5 minutes?
Yeah.
4 minutes without a goal.
That was another good example, though, of the Vikings taking their time. They started their play with 31 seconds left on the shot clock. Even though they created the foul, they drew the foul, 9 seconds was on the clock with her free position.
Wow. Controlled by Park. To net, shot, save, taken by St. John's. Nice work by Juliana Workman. And the ball comes up. And it's controlled. And we had a foul and a loss of the headgear. Eye gear. With 13 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in regulation, it crosses all the way to our side of the field, the bench side. Number 19, Alex Kopsel, brings it up. And a loss out of bounds on an errant pass. Unforced error. Back to the Bruins. Ball back to St. John's. And another whistle. And a timeout by St. John's. Using one of their two timeouts. 12:37 remaining in regulation. 9-9, Bruins and Vikings. Here in the second half. So we'll take a quick timeout. We'll be back to you in just a moment. Hope you're enjoying this contest in the 2023 B Conference Championships here at USA Lacrosse. We'll be back to you in just a moment.
Yeah.
Okay, we're coming back to the action here. The timeout is over, and more lacrosse. 12:37 remaining in the second half. Bruins 9, Vikings 9. St. John's in control. Ball movement. Looking for cutters. Collision down front. Shot stopped by the goalie from the Bruins, Mac Howie. Loose ball up in the air, and it's going to be St. John's. Look in front, shot, scoots through, and picked up by the Bruins on the ground ball. And as they now move it up, Rosenbaum takes it behind the net, moves it around to number 26, Keenan Clark, and out to number 21, Ridgely Smith, and she settles it down. Rosenbaum jukes, solid defense, interception, but gets it back. And moves it over to Ridgely Smith. Smith with the left hand over to the right. Flips it over to Rosenbaum. She looks, she steps, nothing there. Keenan Clark jukes. Loss. And it's going to be given to Keenan Clark on the free ball. Free position. Up against Juliana Workman, goalie. And movement in front. No call. And picked up by St. John's. Errant pass all the way to the other side. Still controlled by St. John's. And the goalie will walk it up. 9 minutes, 42 seconds remain. And St. John's looks to clear. And they do. And dump off to Addison Scanlon. And she'll move it around counterclockwise behind the net. And we've come all the way around to Scanlon. Now we're going to do it again. 30 seconds on the shot clock. Cut to move in front. Nothing there. Now another juke. And we got a violation. A foul on Park. And moving inside. Taken away by Park. And we're sprinting up the far sideline again. And they'll set up. they'll move it around counterclockwise. No, this time they'll move it clockwise. And collision, and down they go. A foul called on St. John's. Out by Keenan Clark and set up in front for Kitchen. Shot hits the pipes, comes off strong and out of bounds. And ball to the Bruins. Minutes 53 seconds remain. Another errant pass, but stays with the Bruins. Step and juke, movement, nothing there. Double teamed and pulls back out. Now Rosenbaum over to Kitchen. Kitchen looks. Moving in front, look. Like we have a penalty on number 21, Kaylee Storm. 2 minutes. And Kitchen will have the free position. And she jumped it. And the ball is going to get turned over to St. John's as they try to clear. Take it over and do clear. St. John's will work on that penalty, work the time down. Got an opening in the middle, shot! Hits the pipes, comes back out, and is controlled by the Bruins. Now they've got numbers, 4-on-3. But they pull up and set up. 4:47 remaining in regulation. They got numbers coming in. Nobody there. Shot. Another one hits the pipes. And a player's down near the crease. Injured player, number 21, coming off Kaylee Storm, coming into the game, number 15, I'm sorry, 21 was Ridgely Smith coming off, 15 is Carolyn Hoffman coming into the game. And Park controls. Shot, move, nothing. Taken by St. John's. And they'll look to clear. So they go up the sideline. And they do. They clear it over. And now they're going to set up. Knotted at 9-9. Penalty going to run off in 4 seconds. And it does. And both teams back to full strength. And St. John's controls the ball with 3 minutes and 45 seconds left. Pass in front, shot, score! And the goal is getting waved off by the official. And given to Park. And Park brings it up and clears in the middle of the field. And now Park with 3:22 remaining. And now another whistle and a timeout by Park. So 3 minutes and 12 seconds remain. Park with no more timeouts. The Vikings with one. And we are knotted up at 9 here in the B Conference Championship. So we'll take a quick timeout. Be back to you in about 30 seconds for the remainder of this game. And the teams make their way back into position. Nine. 3 minutes, 8 seconds remaining. Kitchen, back out front. Ridgely Smith, they're going to work it around. Mishandle, but still in control. Look, spin, nothing there. Solid defense by St. John's as the Bruins look for an opening. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Movement. Back behind. Kitchen takes it. Looks to make a move around front. Shoots down low. No good. kick save, and Bruins stay in control. Back on top, 2 minutes remaining. Look in front. Back to the top. Kitchen. Gonna get double teamed. Pass. Kitchen takes it behind the net. It's a quick move in front and scores! Nice quick move. Goes high into the right hand corner. Juking back in front of the net.
She's shown us that move before. That's something that St. John's needs to be on their toes and know that Cassandra Kitchen's not only a righty, but she's got that wicked quick step back with her left. She doesn't need much of an angle to get that shot off, Larry.
No, now it's 10-9. Park with the lead. An all-important draw coming up. It'll be Maya Graham taking it against Cassandra Kitchen. One minute, 14 seconds. The race to the ball. Picked up by St. John's. And now timeout by St. John's. So we come down to the end here. St. John's going to set up a set play, I guess, Morgan. Who do you go to here? Who's your go-to person?
I'm gonna go with the classic draw and dump here. It seemed to have worked in the first half in a few situations, but they gotta be patient. They can't put too much zip on their pass. They can't force the pass. I think my go-to here, just because shoot to get hot, shoot to stay hot, and the last goal we had, even though it was pulled back, was Mia Graham, I believe, number 25.
Yep, Maya Graham.
Maya Graham.
Yeah.
I apologize.
No.
I don't have a sheet in front of me.
No, you don't. Doing a great job without a sheet in front of you. Good. Good, 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 good.
Who are you going to?
I think this time, Addison Scanlon.
Okay.
That was my
number two.
I think a quick dump. And a pick and a go to goal. We'll see what happens. And ball's in play. And a pass gets through.
That's that draw and dump I was talking about, but the forced part. They're going to set something up again.
And we got a foul called. And it looks like it's going to be Christina Hindle. It's going to get the free position right in front. Score! knotted up again as St. John scores the tying goal. Waiting for the official call here. Waiting for the official announcement on the goal award. Kaylee Storm credited with the goal. And now with 25 seconds, St. John's controls. 20 seconds remaining. And they score! And there's a no goal, it's waved off.
A dangerous shot call.
A dangerous shot call made, and a yellow card given.
I have to tell you, Larry, I think I disagree with that.
Yeah, we're getting a discussion by the officials. And it's gonna,
I believe that's also her second yellow card.
And a long pass down. And looks like we will have overtime here in the B Conference Championship. And we will have overtime. We will wait for overtime rules to apply. And we'll come back to you in just a moment for this overtime as the officials and the coaches are sorting things out. And we'll be back to you in just a moment. And as we come back, we're in the same position we were when we left. Officials did a coin flip on the field. Captains from coaches from both teams meeting with the officials. So we will have 3-minute periods. But again, we'll wait for the official announcement there.
Okay, and our overtime will be a 3-minute period, sudden victory. If we get to the end of the first 3-minute period, teams will switch ends of the field and we will continue playing until someone scores a goal. So again, we're going to start off with 3 minutes, sudden victory.
So there's a 3-minute sudden victory. And then we'll change ends of the field if there is no goal score. And we'll play 3-minute periods until there is a goal scored and the end of our contest.
We encourage our fans and spectators to continue to support our athletes, coaches, and officials in a positive manner. We ask that at the end of the game, spectators, students, everyone, please do not rush the field. Thank you.
And we're just about ready to begin. Our first 3-minute period, sudden victory. We will change ends of the field and we'll go to the draw. Officials making their way to position. On the draw will be Christina Hindel for St. John's and Cassandra Kitchen for Park. And the draw controlled by St. John's. Addison Scanlon. Park putting the pressure on. They're disrupting the normal setup that St. John's likes, and it's going to force a turnover. And the turnover goes to Scanlon as she comes up. Sorry, it goes to Kitchen as she comes up. Makes a juke and pulls back out. And now the Bruins set up. Looking for a pass. And it is an errant pass that turns over to St. John's. A little bit of the jitters of overtime here. And the goalie for St. John's now going to walk it up. Takes it back over to the far side. Now to the middle. And a cut up the middle of the defense. And now St. John's is setting things up. The movement, cut, poke. And this is going to be a free position to St. John's coming up. Cramping going on, injury with the Park player. Get free position right in front. Coming in, shot, score! St. John's wins! St. John's. Addison Scanlon with the goal. And St. John's is your B Conference 2023 IAAN champion in lacrosse. Park team devastated. And St. John's elated on the field. As St. John's comes up as your victor, 11-10. And we'll have the presentation of the runner-up plaque and the bowl to the champions. The Bruins will get the runner-up plaque. The championship will go to the Vikings, and that will be presented in just a few moments. We'll have both teams come over for their handshake, and then your presentation. Great game played by both teams tonight. Now to line up for the handshake. Ceremonial handshake.
We would like to thank all the fans and congratulate the athletes for a fantastic game. Way to go, ladies. Quite an accomplishment. And now for our awards. The first runner up, the Bruins from Park School. Please have your captains come forward to receive your plaque. And now, for the B Conference champions, the Vikings from St. John's Catholic Prep. Please have your captains come forward.
The Vikings go receive their bowl. However, they're having more fun getting their picture taken in front of the scoreboard in this 11-10 victory over the Bruins. It came with 1:56 into the overtime. And it's been a great evening of lacrosse here, great day and evening of lacrosse, great 2 days of lacrosse here at the USA Lacrosse Center. I'm Larry Dukes and Morgan Knox. We want to thank you for joining us, and we'll see you at another IAAM or MIA championship real soon. Thank you, and good night, and congratulations to both teams.